Welcome investors to the 40 Finance Channel. My name's Jeff Beers. Today I got five crazy Wall Street bets for 2021. This is a Friday afternoon that I'm recording this. And you know, these aren't so far-fetched of ideas, but they are definitely above and beyond what I would normally do here on the channel. And if you're not familiar with Wall Street Bets and you see the little logo there, it's like it's a group over at Reddit. And frankly, not safe for work at all and potentially offending. So be careful if you're sensitive. And these guys basically just make fun of themselves for doing stupid trades, right? That inevitably end up at zero and beyond. So if you're into the stock market, definitely check it out if you're looking for some humor. But for this video, this is my, you know, five versions of a crazy Wall Street bet. Just a reminder, particularly for this video, that my stock picks and projections, they're just my opinion for your entertainment. Please make sure you do your own research before investing in any stock. And if you like stock analysis and fun videos like this, then please subscribe to the 40 Finance channel. Give the video a like. Thank you to everyone who's helped support the channel so far. And final call out, if you're interested in joining my email list, link in the description. I will send you my 15-minute stock analysis PDF as soon as you sign up. So check out the description for more information on that. All right, so we need some parameters anytime you're going to do something like this, especially me, because I'm not just going to waste my time and say, you know, Tesla to $6 million or something like that. So I tried to put a framework together. Number one, they're all bullish bets. They're all emotion, momentum type picks. We're not going to get into fundamentals. I'm not going to try to use data to support this. I might make some mentions, but I do inherently think that they could happen in the right scenario. Third point there, please just assume I do not have any positions in any of these stocks. To be fair, I do, but I am not in any way saying that this is what is going to happen. You know, quit your job and bet everything on this. That is not what we're talking about. And four, in a lot of these cases, and every time I make a projection, I remind folks like, hey, you might have to sell at a very certain time to make this projection true, right? So if somebody tells you that a stock is going to go up to $100 over the next 6 months, just keep in mind that on the last day of the 6 month period, that's not what we're talking about. We're saying like that can hit $100 in the next day, right? And then that's it, you hit it, it's over. And if you wake up and wait and it's, you know, 3 months later and it's down to $2, well, that wasn't really the scope of the projection. The projection was it was gonna hit 100. So keep that in mind. That's more of like a lesson for like across all stock projections, is you have to watch what you invest in and get out at whatever time frame you think is right. All right, projection number one that's near and dear to my heart, and it's going to get even harder, is that Visa and PayPal both of those stocks climb over $250 before the end of 2021. And we're actually in the midst of a dip here on this Friday. And I think that they've both given back a couple percentage points. So you see that I highlighted there off to the left, PayPal at 195. I think that's at 191 or 192 today. Visa, kind of the same thing, 181, 182. And just to prove that I am calling for something that is obscure, off to the right side, you know, the best performing analysts are saying plus 14%, plus 21%. I think Visa and PayPal can hit 250. I think they've both had some challenges, way more so for Visa, and that some of those challenges go away. On the PayPal side, they've been very innovative during this stretch, and I think some of that innovation is actually going to take shape around the midpoint of next year. All right, next one, GM and NIO stocks grow more than Tesla in 2021. And here we're talking about a percentage gain, right? They're not gonna go above Tesla's stock price, most likely. And you look at the prices that we have here today, Tesla at 400, this is before the market sell-off on Friday, GM at 35, NIO at 32. And you see what the analysts are saying off to the side. A lot of them have NIO down from its current level. GM up, but only plus 25%. And then Tesla, they got about a 13% gain on it. And of course, analysts and me have been wrong on Tesla across the board. What I'm going to say, though, is that GM and NIO both of those stocks from day one all the way to the last trading day, December 31st, GM and NIO stocks, I think will end that period with a larger percentage gain than Tesla. So let's just say NIO doubled to 60, they would be up 50%. And GM did the same thing, and Tesla only went up to $500 or whatever. Obviously, the percentage gain for GM and NIO would be higher, and they would actually land that bet. All right, big bet number three, we got the 2021 housing crash. It ain't happening, guys. You see a lot of people talking about the housing crash. You hear a lot of people talking about forbearance, evictions, all this stuff. It is not happening. The world is ready to get back even more into housing than they are now. Interest rates are going to be low. The only exception to this rule is I would say that probably the biggest cities and California, of course, because that whole place is a wreck. But, you know, New York, Chicago downtown, LA downtown, those specific geographies are going to struggle and could very well crash. But from the USA, like as a whole, I think that housing is going to be just fine. No crash. I wasn't going to do data, but we got some Black Knight research. You can see the number of seriously delinquent mortgages, 90 plus days, fell by 43,000 in September, marking the first such improvement since the start of the pandemic. On the negative side, more than 2.3 million homeowners, five times the number heading into 2020, remain 90 days or more past due, but not in foreclosure. And remember, being in foreclosure just happens. They can't evict you necessarily, but it doesn't mean you can't be in foreclosure. But then we got even more positives in this past September. Early stage delinquencies continue to show strong improvement. And then after a slight pullback in August, prepayment activity jumped above 3% in September for the first time in more than 16 years, fueled by record low interest rates and elongated buying season. So at the end of the day, this one's going to be hard to measure because it could be an opinion on the housing crash. But the bottom line for me, if you're in Zillow, Rocket, Redfin, Invitation Homes, residential REITs, whatever it is that you're doing in the housing sector, I wouldn't worry too much about it crashing because of a housing crash. An individual company might have a problem, but overall housing related stocks I think are going to be just fine next year. And once we get into that spring summer season, you know, I'm a big holder of Rocket. They're dumping right now, but I'm holding on because next spring summer, in my opinion, it's going to be a huge boom. All right, bet number four, Netflix climbs over $700 before the end of 2021. I've been studying Netflix a lot lately, and just the way that their company is maturing and the way that the profitability is rolling in for them, and then factor in what's going on at movie theaters right now. I think Netflix is really going to capitalize on what's happened to movie theaters and what we're likely to see in the winter of this year. So I like where they're going. You see on the screen on the left, price today at $504. It's actually probably like $495 because the market was down again today. And the best analyst price for next year is at $572. I'm saying $700. That doesn't even make sense from a fundamental standpoint. But hey, we're calling strange bets and here we are. Last one, and this just hit me last night. Callaway Golf climbs to over $27 by the end of 2021. Callaway Golf just bought the rest of Top Golf. Top Golf, of course, is like a family entertainment center. They have like the three tiers of driving ranges that you hit out. Go there with my kids a couple times a year. We don't even golf, but we go and hit the balls and blow, you know, at least $100 at that place. I love it. Callaway was already struggling this year because golf hasn't been the same golf that we normally see. And most of the pundits are out here saying like, geez, you blew a ton of money on Top Golf. You're never going to get it back, blah, 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 blah. And they lost whatever, $5 or $6 as soon as announcing it. I think it's a win. I think recovery back for Callaway to the $21 mark is easy peasy. And then from there, by the end of 2021, getting through, we'll call it hopefully a regular summer. Do not own this stock right now, but it's definitely one that's on my list. It's just as this market has dipped, I had to make sure that I was putting money into my conviction stocks. So hopefully I'll come up with some more cash and we'll get into Callaway Golf at some point. All right, guys. So those are my five big Wall Street bets for the year 2021. Again, in my opinion, these aren't like super crazy, but they're crazy enough for an analytical fundamental type guy that on paper, they probably shouldn't happen. But if we've noticed anything in the past year, particularly with the stock market, is man, stuff you couldn't even imagine what happened certainly has. So I just wanted to share these with you. Let me know what you think in the comments. Please give me a like and subscribe if you enjoy this type of content. We'll see you on the next video.